Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Well, as you can see, we're trying a different technology this week in recording this liturgy. We have now cameras installed in St. Teresa's Church for live streaming in the future, and right now we're using it to record our Mass as we continue our social separation. Looking forward to next week when we may gather again as a physical body of Christ rather than a virtual one. But we are always conscious of how sin infects our world, and we also are always conscious of how God loves us and forgives us. And as we need to be disciples of this Jesus and apostles who share Jesus with others, we need to be saved first. We need to be forgiven. And so we call to mind our sins and how we are infected by the sins of the world, and receive God's mercy and compassion. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come to us in word and in sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
We bless you.
Let us pray. O God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
And now, let us hear some words from sacred scripture in how to welcome Jesus as disciples of Jesus.
A reading from the second book of Kings. One day, Elisha came to Shunem, where there was a woman of influence who urged him to dine with her. Afterward, whenever he passed by, he used to stop there to dine. So she said to her husband, "I know Elisha is a holy man of God. Since he visits us often, let us arrange a little room on the roof and furnish it for him with a bed, table, chair, and lamp, so that when he comes to us, he can stay there." Sometime later, Elisha arrived and stayed in the room overnight. Later, Elisha said, "Can something be done for her?" His servant, Gehazi, answered, "Yes, she has no son, and her husband is getting on in years." Elisha said, "Call her." When the woman had been called and stood at the door, Elisha promised, "This time next year, you'll be fondling a baby son." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
The promises of the Lord I will sing forever. Through all generations, my mouth shall proclaim your faithfulness. For you have said, "My kindness is established forever." In heaven, you have confirmed your faithfulness.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
Bless the people who know the joyful shout. In the light of your countenance, O Lord, they walk. At your name, they rejoice all day, and through your justice, they are exalted.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
You are the splendor of their strength, and by your favor, our horn is exalted. For to the Lord belongs our shield, and to the Holy One of Israel, our King.
Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in the newness of life. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. As to his death, he died to sin once and for all. As to his life, he lives for God. Consequently, you too must think of yourselves as dead to sin and living for God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his apostles, "Whoever loves father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever does not take up his cross and follow after me is not worthy of me. Whoever finds his life will lose it, and whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. Whoever receives you receives me, and whoever receives me receives the one who sent me. And whoever receives a prophet because he is a prophet will receive a prophet's reward. And whoever receives a righteous man because he is a righteous man will receive a righteous man's reward. And whoever gives only a cup of cold water to one of these little ones to drink, because the little one is a disciple, amen, I say to you, he will surely not lose his reward." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In Jesus' day, family life was center of all of society. That the family bonds defined you, and the family bonds gave you life. And the family bonds were a bond that was more than just a core family like we think of today. It's more of an extended family, but in more like a clan, perhaps. And it is in that kind of clan, in those kinds of relationships, and in those kinds of bonds that a person would live and move and have their being. And there was great attachment, and as I said, great definition, and all of their life would come from this kind of lifestyle, faithfulness to one's extended family. And Jesus, at this point in the Gospel of Matthew, is starting to let those who are following him know what it really means to be a disciple, to be a follower of Jesus. And so he says that whoever finds his life will lose it, and whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. In other words, if you're going to be a disciple of Jesus, you have to let go of the life that you are used to. In Jesus' day, it was these connections in the extended family that defined you and gave you life. And why would you have to lose that? Is because if you're a disciple of Jesus, you will no longer be defined by your family, but by the love of God. And no longer will you need to have the life from your family, but the life that God gives you through Jesus. And he says in a little more specific way, whoever does not take up his cross and follow after me is not worthy of me. That in losing one's life, there is indeed a suffering. There is indeed a cross. And this is the first time Jesus mentions a cross in the Gospel of Matthew. It becomes more prominent, as we know, as the Gospel continues. But the day-to-day suffering that comes with being a disciple of Jesus, which requires much patience, much endurance, much enduring and being patient with the world at large, and also much courage in talking about Jesus and sharing how important Jesus is with you to others. It can be quite a cross. If you take up that cross by giving up those things that you're attached to, that make you afraid, that you think gives you life and may give you life to some degree, if you give that up and take up the cross, you will discover more life, more fulfillment than you possibly can handle. And that life is both a spiritual life, but also a material life as well. And it may not necessarily mean that you're going to be like floating on a cloud all the time. There is certainly struggle, but with that struggle, there is striving. And with that striving, there is life. And if we strive after Jesus, all we can have is life. Paul says in the letter to the Romans that if we die with Christ, we will also rise with Christ. That's our baptism. Those are the promises that we make as a disciple, to die on the cross with Jesus so that we might live a new life with Jesus. With the global conditions of the pandemic that we are still currently experiencing, and even though we are coming together again slowly and carefully, there is still the influence of the pandemic, and that the coronavirus has not been eradicated. And we are certainly doing a fantastic job in this part of the country in keeping the coronavirus at bay. And we must continue to do so. But in those kinds of struggles, and it certainly is a struggle, isn't it? How much fear, how much courage, how much patience must we have in order to be as successful as we are? And it is in Christ Jesus that we can have the fullness of life, that in amidst all of the struggle and in amidst all of this patience that we have to expend, that we can indeed find abundance of life. It's not easy for anyone, even for a disciple, but a disciple can discover a new life, a new ardor in whatever difficulties and challenges that come in the world. And as we begin to come together next week to publicly worship in all our churches, we must always first and foremost remind ourselves that we are defined first and foremost as a righteous person, as a person who is forgiven by Jesus, and with that forgiveness is a disciple of Jesus. And as a disciple, united in our baptism, we can proclaim God's word, God's presence to a world that really needs it. And so as we look forward to coming together, we also look forward to being greater disciples than we ever were before by dying to the things that we have been attached to, picking up our cross, and in that striving, achieve even more abundant life. So now let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father of the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became a man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church.
I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
When Jesus was dying on the cross, Jesus prayed. Jesus prayed for the needs of the world. And so as Jesus prays through us as disciples, we offer our prayers with Jesus for the needs of the world.
For our church and our nation, that we may respond to the promptings of the Holy Spirit to embrace the hopes and fears of oppressed people of color, to see the sinfulness of racism, and to act together to end racism and its violence, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our communities of Bethlehem and Woodbury, that we may have the grace to look beyond our own prejudices, participate in the body of Christ, and to reveal the love of neighbor and enemy, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a renewal in our parish like a new Pentecost, that with thanksgiving for the past and confidence in the future, we may boldly follow Jesus, guided by the Holy Spirit, to create a new normal that proclaims Jesus as our reason for living, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For volunteers to come forward to help with welcoming, guiding, and cleaning, so that we may begin a safe return to public worship next weekend, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those impacted by COVID-19, especially the sick, the healers, the researchers, the civil and religious leaders, the essential workers, the unemployed, the anxious, the addicted, and the bereaved, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For caring for Bethlehem and Community Services Council of Woodbury and all those serving the most vulnerable in our communities, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the protection of those serving our country, for world peace, and for the dignity of human life from the womb to the tomb, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish mission, Children of the Light, for the boys who live there, for the boys and girls who study there, for the men and women who serve there, and for everyone everywhere who support them with prayers and resources, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Elaine Krish, Patricia Margatis, Deacon Joseph Guzaukas, and for Christopher Suriello, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions written in our two books of hope, the intentions recorded on our parish prayer line, and for the intentions we know and hold in the silence of our hearts. United with our universal prayer, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. O Jesus, living in Mary, come and live in your disciples. In the potential of your love, in the radiance of your light, in the abundance of your life, overcome every oppressing force, that we might not live for ourselves, but live in the power of your Spirit, for the glory of God and his kingdom. Amen.
Amen.
Spirit, theirs is the kingdom of God.
Pray, my sister and brothers, that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name,
for our good and good of all, his holy church.
O God, who graciously accomplished the effects of your mysteries, grant that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of these sacred gifts. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Having heard the sacred scripture and how it might apply to our lives, we put that into the context of the good news of what Jesus has done for us. So listen closely to the words of this great Eucharistic prayer. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed us in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works, through Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Make holy, therefore, these gifts by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. And at the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be in your presence, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. And remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Leonard, our Archbishop, Juan Miguel, our auxiliary, all the clergy, all the religious, and all laity. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus the Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
And now we pray with Jesus in the way that Jesus taught us to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
At home, you can shake hands or offer one another a sign of peace. Behold him, Jesus, the Prince of Peace, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
O Lord, even though I cannot receive you presently, please come, at least spiritually, into my heart. Amen.
Let us pray. O Lord, may this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, so that bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Well, next week we will be beginning coming back together for public worship on the weekend. I'm sure many of us are looking forward to doing that. During the week, early in the week, there will be an email that will state the schedule of the weekend masses, and also an email asking for help for the masses so that we can welcome people back with all of the procedures of having to take temperatures and having our names checked off on a list and having to sign up ahead of time, that we might create a welcoming environment in spite of all of the procedures that we have to follow. And so I will be looking for volunteers for each of the masses, not just for this weekend, but for the weeks that come, in order to make our celebrations prayerful and fruitful and really be a sense of the body of Christ. So look for those emails, and if you don't have the email, you can sign up for the email by emailing the office or calling the office, or you just can check the website. It should be on the website at the early part of the week, Monday or Tuesday, this coming week as well. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We let us go, as the Mass is ended, to announce the Gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.